Alright. Camera's actually working. Audio's actually working. My god. Alright, let's see. It's got us up and rolling. One of the new contract, but it's another part recovery. 1.2 meters. This shouldn't be that big, though. Well, sure wish I'd saved that last craft we used for that. Although that gets us almost nothing. I'm gonna skip that one. We're gonna pay more for the craft than actually completing the contract. Today, I'm thinking maybe some contract completion really needs to be done. I could probably do these temperature surveys if I'm careful. This one I should just get out of the way. And we need to do these observational surveys. Go away, Windows. No one likes your pop-ups. I might start with this. I might start trying to do a moon landing, since that's so easy. Since that is such an easy thing to do. Let me get the chat up and working here. Didn't have it working. There we go. Alright. Let's get this stuff. Let's go to Valentina Kerman Station. We kind of missed our window, so there's going to have to be some time warp involved, unfortunately, if I wanted to do this. And this is a contract mission. This is not going to be a science mission, so I am going to use a pilot. I'm going to let our scientists keep working in the labs. Sidre's not done a moon landing? I thought he'd done a moon landing. Am I wrong? I guess I am. Tedman, I thought had as well, actually. Maybe I'm losing my mind. Maybe I'm just imagining that. Sidre. Yeah, he's gonna take the Prime Lander. And just a little bit. Yeah, I think I'm gonna get him set up to take the Prime Lander. And I know I could just transfer him down to it, but this is just way more fun. A chance to inspect it as well. Make sure there's nothing wrong with it. Which there shouldn't be. Everything should be reset from last time. Yeah, looks like it. Huh. Bring it towards the wrong lander. There we go, that's the Prime Lander. Prime Lander. Everything looks reset on there as well. So you need to get fuel in it. Top it off. roll to here. Do an unmanned launch down to this scan. That is our busted lander. And the SOS from where it originally was. And the temperature scan should be right about there. And we just couldn't get to it. Fuel the spare fuel tanks. Now I did notice last time our extra tank was not set up with the same fuel priority as this one was. Although now that's the same as well. What on earth happened here? Does that reset every time? So I don't know if that means that this is going to burn first or last. Really, I want this one to burn first because it's making this asymmetric in its weight, which is bad. Don't want to have that. Hard to maneuver. I could just manually transfer it into the center of the vehicle if I set it up wrong, but it would just be right. So this will be our start point, and then I might do some craziness with Minmus. I do already have a Minmus lander in Kerbin orbit. I think I've got a way to get a crew and the lander itself over to the deep space gateway. And start doing Minmus landings while we assemble our interplanetary transfer vehicle. Tanks are now full. Should have more than enough RCS as well. We do indeed. Alright. We can start working on setting up our initial orbit. Our orbit. Sanity check. Okay, this one ended up a little short field. No, it's right. Never mind. Alright. Prime lander on the way. So now we need to not use RCS for that, because that's a waste. An excellent start. We need to set up an inclination change. What do we need to do? We're gonna need to do an inclination change right about here-ish. So this is gonna be a slightly more expensive mission fuel-wise. I may leave a smaller orbit here. So I'm going to have to do this early. Let's get it down to maybe 12,000 meters. We got a little bit of time before we have to do our inclination change here to first. Okay, that's not at all what I wanted to do, thank you. Nope, that's, again, not what I want to do. I would like to set up a maneuver node, please. Bingo. That should do fine. So that'll be our next maneuver, and then here we'll do our inclination change. Even though it is less efficient to do the lowering of the orbit before we attempt this, I want to do it anyway, so we can line this up quickly. Just a matter of time savings rather than fuel savings at this point. Things are getting pretty routine over here for moon landing, so I'm not terribly worried at the end of the day. Just a little more. A little less. There we go. Nice and slow. Nice and slow adjustment. That should do nicely. And of course, that might change a little bit once we come around to the maneuver, but keep an eye on it. And of course, need to keep an eye on our Minmus travelers. We've got Surveyor 2 on its way. It should be coming into a Minmus encounter shortly, as well as our refining module. There we go. A refinery. And somehow this all got royally effed up. Yeah, typically you don't want to impact the moon. It's usually less than desirable. I'm gonna cancel that maneuver node just so I can reset it later. Once I have a better idea of how the rotation of the moon's going to impact our maneuver here. I'm going to warp just a little closer. Volume low, music is roughly equal to you. Just a smidge or two adjustment, nothing extreme. Okay, I can do that. Alright, now. We got 48 seconds. Before we get to our maneuver node, we're gonna go ahead and cancel out. First of all, I'm gonna deploy our solar panel just to help us out a little bit when we come back around, so I don't forget it. We're gonna switch over to stability assist, staging mode, so we can throttle up, and we're going to aim directly for the maneuver node, so we can time our burn properly. Throttle when we're 1 second away from the maneuver. I think that's a little bit too quiet. Over there. We got a another adjustment here. Altitude change anyway, no need to be terribly precise for this. Alright, now, we're actually coming up on where we want to start doing that inclination change. So what we want to do is aim this way and shift our more efficient to do this as combined maneuvers, so that's what we're going to do. So we're going to combine our... inclination with our retrograde. We're going to have a 20 second burn coming up in 28 seconds, so we need to maneuver this one quickly. 10 seconds away, we're going to start burning. Consider he'll be on his way to the desired landing zone. Using quite a bit of his fuel, I might add. We no longer have the capture vehicle to help us out as well. So, we need to be careful with our landing. Make sure we don't waste any fuel there. We don't need to. Let's check out how we look. Pretty good there. Periaps is still at 12. Apogee's still at 12. So, we don't have any issues with our altitude. Altitude looks good. So now, we need to start planning our descent. So we need to add a maneuver to overshoot. That's what we want to do. We actually want to plan to overshoot by a considerable margin. And then we can pick our landing zone more carefully as we descend. So at this point, we're going to detach orbital segment here. Of the lander. Leaving just the lander itself. Oh, and that just canceled our maneuvers for some reason. That's interesting. Guess we weren't controlling from the lander. That's a surprise. There we are. As I said, we want to try and overshoot slightly, because as we get much lower, we are going to be doing more braking, so that's probably about where we want it, which is going to be an 8-second burn. Our orbital module, of course, just for docking, just to recover this, dock with it, and then help it dock with the station. Got 4 minutes, 53 seconds before our maneuver. I think we need to worry about this a lot more than the min-miss right now, but I am going to check it just to be safe. Let's warp to maneuver. So we will be coming up rapidly. Yeah, see, this made this burn last. That's frustrating. So balance the fuel back out so it is centered mass on this to the engine, so we're not burning off course when we do this. We're going to have to wait to about 4 seconds away from our maneuver node to make sure that we don't come in short. And I am going to use this for timing, but I am going to just target retrograde. So there we go. Full throttle. Okay. That should be fine as is. Now what I want to do, I want to activate location on this this landing site. So as I flip us, should point me in the right direction. As you can see right there, yep. As we aim prograde, there it is. So, but we're not going to be landing facing prograde. We're going to be landing facing a retrograde so we don't smash into the ground. We don't want to accelerate into the ground. That so we're going to wait till we're much closer. Looks like those landing zones, that's all very tightly packed. Now what I could probably do... could do some madness. Point reversed. Forward. Reversed. Reversed. Perfect. Now we can aim prograde. Now we can see how we're doing. Excellent. Looking like we're pretty well on target, actually. Retrograde, and now we need to really slow down because we are going very fast. Dangerously fast. I was not paying attention to how fast we were going. How low we were going. We need to make some bunny hops, we'll do that. I'm not going to smash us into the surface. It would not be good for crew health. OSHA has things against smashing crew into celestial bodies, so it's just a bad practice. We way overshot. I did not think I was overshooting by that much. That's not good. Alright, let's go back the other direction. Screw it. Okay. This is how to waste fuel. This right here, this thing we're doing. Back retrograde. So where is this landing site? We're pretty close to it. Just on the other side of this crater we're flying over. So right about here-ish. Yeah, that puts us pretty close to the landing zone, I think. See, they are like a crew report on the surface, on the surface, on the surface. Okay. That's fine. Who likes wasting fuel? I like wasting fuel. No, I actually don't. I'm just really good at it. Just really good at wasting fuel. So... I feel like I should be curb netting this and seeing how high the terrain features are and help myself out a little bit. But it might be just a little dangerous to do that when we're going fast. Where's curb net? Curb net, where are you? Where's curb net? Well, I think I can only do that with the probe. Correct. Altitude. 3.4. Wow, okay, we are pretty close to the ground. 500 meters above the ground now. 400 meters. Meters above the surface. Meters above the surface. We can start to throttle down a little bit. Okay. Back up. 100 meters above the surface now. Right around that 3 meters per second mark. Or less. Less is better. There we are. Alright, so we only wasted a lot of fuel. How close are we actually to these zones? Apparently not all that close. Let's see. Crew report? Well, this is a new science experiment. It's at least something. Have I not landed in the Midlands? Seems I have. Why would I not have a crew report from the Midlands? Closer to that to take data. Take data. Start experiments. EVA report. That's new. Oh, I might have put my unmanned probe on the Midlands. That one test lander might have ended up there. That might be what happened. Flag, buddy. Forget if this is landing site echo. How many landing sites do I have? Bravo. My poorly spelled Alpha, Delta, Charlie, Echo. Okay, yep, so this would be landing zone Fox, actually. Try that again. Plant the flag. Let's go store some experiments. Now let's look at this contract real quick and see what I really need to do here. So I don't have a terrible amount. Oh, they're EVA reports and surface samples. Oh, okay, yeah, we're good. We're fine. I don't know why I was trying to get that, pod so dead over there. I didn't really need to. EVA. So where are these sites now? So the first site is this way. So I've got, of course, my EVA propellant. I'm going to monitor that very carefully. Go up. Have my keys in reverse there. Just face plant. You're good. Good, Sidri. Alright. Try that again. I was using space instead of shift. Used it to jump, so it just seemed natural. So of course, as I said, this is for a contract. Don't have to worry too much about this being repeat science. It's really all about the contract this time. I'll monitor my fuel carefully. to call, give you a propellant of, 3. Here we are. As our, abort level of monoprop. Perfect. Okay. Now we need to take a EVA report, I believe. Is that right? No. Which zone did it say we're at? So maybe it's surface sample. There we go. Okay, there's the surface sample. How close are we to the next? Should be this way. So we at least landed somewhat close. Still see the lander back there. It's only about a kilometer away. Definitely would be good to have a rover. I did say 3.5 was going to be our abort fuel mode. So I'm going to hopefully come up on this zone quickly. Actually, I am closer to this zone, looks like. See if we can get this zone without EVAing, EVA fueling. We should have enough for the return. Is there a camera mode that lets me pan around and watch them run? Guess not. So he's running as best he can. Wish it told me how far away I am from this. It looks like I'm fairly close, but it looked like I was close to the other one. It's as far as it lets me zoom in. Thankfully, it's... Actually, I think moving slightly closer to the pod as I head this way. Ever so slightly. Then I just need to head back, put the reports back into the lander. Then head back for the final EVA report. Where is this zone? Really does look like I'm like on top of it. Right, I'm gonna do the thing that I said I shouldn't do. Technically, I did say 3.5 is my abort mode. I'm slightly above 3.5. There we go. Yeah, he's fine. And there we go. So now we can take our EVA report. Perfect. So we've got beta and gamma. We need to get, oh no, we have alpha and beta. We need gamma. Now we need to head back to our lander and refill our EVA. Oop. Off we go. Alright. Not bad, actually. I still have 2.5. So, because that was mostly uphill the other way, I might just consider my abort mode closer to 3 for the next run here. So first I'm going to get him back in the cabin to refuel his EVA propellant and store these experiments. Don't want you to do a crew report. Store experiments. Yep, that's fine. Board. Yep. Had to dump some repeat experiments, but that's fine. They're repeats, so it wouldn't do us any good anyway. Alright. Now, the final site. It's off this way. Now we're going quite fast. Probably shouldn't have bothered to go that fast because we're going to have to use the fuel to brake, but whatever. It did seem like it was a long way. Yep, there we go. There's our zone. Well within our abort limit. All right, so then a EVA report. Finishes out our contract. That is a contract complete. We just need to get him back. Wow, that was a whole extra kilometer away. I wonder I couldn't get there on foot. Alright. Let's not go so crazy fast this time. Let's go with maybe 30 meters a second. Compromise between spending more time elevating us and more fuel breaking us when we get there. Kind of a tough compromise there. But this should do fine. I got us a little bit of distance there. It was just a little bit more. There we go. Like a pro. Dump the extra experiment. We already got the contract. We're good there. Okay. Now the trick is this. Going back to orbit with limited fuel. So we need... Where the hell's the orbiter? Wait a minute. It doesn't count that as a pod, does it? It totally does. Why does it count that as a pod? That's bizarre. Sitting there, I thought I might have like smashed into the moon's surface there or something. Freak me out. That would have not been good. We're gonna wait for that to come around. The inclination still leaving that pretty much right overhead. Definitely a good thing. We should be able to get up to orbit pretty fast. We'll leave it like right about there instead of there's our target. And just take off. Yeah. Get some height. Target. And that gives me an idea of what direction we should be going. Cancel that out and start just doing this intelligently. Fudging it a little bit. It's always a little bit terrifying when I do this because I can't see the ground below me. To make sure I'm not smashing into something, but I should be at sufficient altitude at this point. Just playing the game between finishing our orbit and changing our speed retrograde to target to make sure we line up properly. We are burning through quite a bit of fuel while we're doing this. Oop, that was supposed to cancel out faster than that. That's a pretty good intersect already. Timing's just a little off. Our optimal window there. That's okay. So at that rendezvous. So I'm going to make sure we are this burn as effectively as possible. this to be fairly thrust limited so we can actually complete this burn with some degree of accuracy. We need to do 10 meters a second with Delta V. Meters a second of Delta V. Oh, it's under time because it's before I knew that. Okay. Nope, it's not gonna do it. Okay. I forget it. Let's just get to that point. We'll use full throttle. Why not? Why not use full throttle? So what if we accidentally just nosedive into the moon? Is that important? We got a contract. See, that's what I was afraid of. Overshooting. That was quite a bit of overshooting. But here we are, holding steady. 687. I usually do better than that on these rendezvous, but I did do it at direct ascent to rendezvous, so I guess I'm not going to complain about it. Still got a little bit of fuel. Do still need to do the inclination change, though, so that worries me. So what I might do is do the rest of this. From the harness. On. And this is why we have this harness. Makes lander recovery very easy. Means we don't have to haul all this RCS fuel down to the surface of Mun every time we do a landing as well. It saves that critical last bit of fuel that's currently on the lander. Start slowing down pretty soon here. Back off just a little bit, off the RCS, and roll into a position that's more fortuitous for docking here. Make sure we are fairly well aligned. Which we are not. More like that, looks like. Go back to linear mode. Fighting, but using the nav ball to get it precise. Look at that. Perfect. quite well lined up along the axis here. So RCS ports here and here, pretty well aligned. Things will be a little easier to dock with the station once we finally come up to that point. So we go back to staging mode. We need to set the station as our target. And we will need to do an ascending node correction here. We're going to have to start burning here. Pull ourselves out. So that means I'm off my target a little bit. Back the other way. There we go. That's the burn I want. It is going to use the majority of our delta V, but it shouldn't be a major issue. Let's lower our periap slightly, which we will have to fix that. Or no, it doesn't. It raises our apogee significantly. Reading that wrong. So that's what we'll have to correct. Actually, if I do that now... should use less delta V total. So we got 13... Yep. Makes a smaller burn. Just in time. Whoa! What happened there? Why are we spinning? Why are we spinning? That was bad. That's not supposed to happen. Something's wrong. Something's very wrong here. Why are we tipping? What's making us tip? Alright, we're gonna have to cancel this maneuver. We're gonna have to figure this out quickly. While we set up the next burn. Timing is off a little bit. There we go. Alright, now we don't have enough fuel to do this, which is a problem. Why did this throw us off kilter? Ah, we were controlling from the wrong point. We actually increased our... that explains a little bit. Whoops. Okay. It's fine. Just a little bit of RCS boost. helps when we go in the right direction when we go to make our maneuver. Spare 2, still got a little bit of time here. Alright, let's get us right up to the maneuver. It's going to be a 12-second maneuver. We do not have enough fuel to complete it. But we do have monoprop, which should be boosting us. So it's 6 seconds to burn. Well, I might be only on monoprop for a minute, so I might do this 8 seconds from burn. This is a tough call. Do it right at 6. Do it right at 6. Then let's control from here. Let's flip around. Oh, great. Now this isn't working. What the fuck? Oh. I have my RCS on in order to do that. Kind of helps, doesn't it? Oh, silly mistakes, man. Bit of correction. Overshot a little bit. Okay. All right. Should be able to do the rest with monoprop. This is coming back to again me realizing I was wasting fuel. We did get our contract. I'm not going to be too upset. At this point, we just need to catch up to the station. We do have a tighter orbit all the way around. We do have a safe orbit. Shouldn't be too much a problem. Just a routine moon landing, running out of fuel. Totally routine. We've got this in the bag. It's 100 times acceleration. Totally under control. Around, and I'll start looking at maneuvers. Yep, there's one. We'll do one more. With one more. Let's check with the maneuver here what this looks like. So we're working with imaginary fuel right now. Yeah, that does not look favorable at all. Let's try another orbit. Because we're going to be rendezvousing near apogee, this is actually going to need to be pretty close. To lined up here before we start doing this. Right there. We've still got some inclination to fix. Quite a bit of inclination, actually. So we're going to try and figure that first. Don't know how long the maneuver is going to take to do. I need to estimate. But 7 meters per second is not so bad. It's telling me it would normally be a 5 second burn time. I'm going to actually see if I can't do it 5 seconds away from the maneuver and see how that treats us. Actually fairly accurate. Okay. Raise our orbit. Need to change our timing. Radially. There we go. Point to intercept. Okay, RCS off, rotational mode, prepare for the next maneuver. Which is again telling us it's 5 seconds, even though it's giving us a completely different amount of delta V. So I don't know where it's getting these numbers. That's kind of concerning. So that would take us 4 times longer. So 10 seconds away is where we're going to do our run. Mental math. Perfect for orbital rendezvous. Just do it in your head. Let's... 10 seconds away is where we're going to do this. Exact as much as possible. I love how it's calculating right here. That's messed up. Okay, actual rendezvous now at 0.3. Okay, that's fine. Relative speed is going to be 32.7 meters per second once again. What we're going to do is we're going to aim retrograde to target. I don't know why this is not letting me... use the smarter... There we go. Re-enabled. Now we can aim retrograde to target. Right around to our rendezvous. We're going to put one maneuver right on it. So I can time this out properly. It should take us about 10 seconds. Or 20 seconds to stop, so we need to be 10 seconds away from it, is what I'm trying to say. Coming up. We are aiming retrograde to target. We are in linear mode. RCS is on. We're going to do this burn with docking thrusters. That's all we got left. It does seem like we're approaching much faster than this is leading me to believe for a maneuver node. Thank you. towards the station. Alright. Now. Back to rotational. Back to controlling from here. Kill the maneuver node. No longer need it. Linear. Alright, let's move in for our rendezvous. And docking. That actually would have been totally doable. If I had not had the direction the wrong way around for that original inclination change. Wasted a lot of fuel doing the wrong inclination change. Just made it worse all the way around. Thankfully, we seem to have a lot of monoprop, and we don't really have a lot of landings left to go. Really, just the one that I'm interested in doing anytime soon. Retract our good solar panel. I can't retract that one, that's right. RCS off, rotation on. What am I doing here? There we go. Aiming north. Roughly. More that way. Okay, and he's home safe. Barely, but he's home safe. Alright, Sidre, we need you to EVA and take those experiments back. to head for the labs. I think the primary lab is shorter on science at the moment. Seems to actually have spare data. Just store those experiments for now. Alright, you can head back over to the crew module. That's one hair-raising mission done. Let's see. Actually fairly topped off on science in both places. So, yeah. I guess it's just going to be excess science for now. It really wasn't the point of the mission anyway. The point of the mission was definitely the contract. And it's good we got that out of the way. There's some easy ones. What are some other easy ones like that one? Vector, suborbital trajectory in the MUN. Easy, but I don't want to waste it yet. Oh, we gotta get Desfin back. This one should be another easy one. Let's take a break from that for a second. Aha! Perfect. Surveyor 2 is ready. Ritz now showing. Yoo-hoo. Where'd you go, buddy? I don't like that it does that. It seems to lose track of them. I have to get him in the space center. Contracts. Test small landing gear. Land at a Kerbin. Talk about an easy one. I'm going to take that and do that real quick. We don't get any easier than that. Launch that just to launch it. Then I'll go back on to Surveyor 2. And there we go. Another contract complete. Cover that.
Oh,
Map 9 asteroids endangering Kerbin with a Sentinel infrared telescope. We have a Sentinel out there, but it's outside of radio contact. But this shouldn't be a terribly hard one to launch. We're gonna do that. Actually, help me take care of another one while I'm at it. Now, let's go and check out that, Surveyor. Here we go, Surveyor 2. About to reach its periaps. Perfect timing. Seven minutes away from periaps. Let's plan out the maneuver. Woo! Okay. No grazie. Oh, we're coming in on retrograde. Not that it's a big deal, because this is just going to be a polar orbit anyway. There we are. So we'll do that maneuver right there. Second burn. Not bad. Not bad at all. So this is a very vital step. This comes back to what our rover was supposed to be helping us do. Before I went and screwed that one up. And that is map the resources on Minmus. Since Minmus is going to be our, well, hopefully anyway, our mining platform. That is going to be our deep space gateway. Still don't know how my cat snores so loud. Oh, we actually have to activate engines to do that. Yep. Didn't realize how perfectly that worked out before. And done. Alright, just a little bit of correction here. Perfect. Excellent, polar orbit. Alright, now... between 25 and 300 kilometers. So yeah, we're gonna have to go a little bit retrograde here. Go there. We got 4 days away from our equalization maneuver. There we go. It's a circular orbit. Very polar. Fantastic. It's only going to be a 1 second burn. And at that point, Surveyor 2 will be in place. And we'll be gathering survey data from our around Midmas. Still have our refinery on the way. Now let's see, we've got 4 days, let's go back to Space Center. I need now be a little interesting. Need to make some kind of transfer vehicle to go between the Midmas station now and Kerbin, since not going to be so easy to use the nuclear vehicle for that. Due to Kerbin's high gravity. So what I'm gonna want to do out on this guy, so we can put all our extras. Let's see what we want. Don't necessarily need a probe core, I don't think. Might be okay with that one. Suitable craft, but see if we can't make something a little more useful. This big old adapter. Might piloted. That's maybe more useful. System. All right. Some solar panels. Preferably a good distance away from where it's supposed to be docking. Also, let's do this. Let's do one other piece of craziness. Pardon me. The dorsal docking port like we had on the other one. Else I need a transfer vehicle really to have. Need some batteries on here. Just to keep it from issues. A couple of those on this side just to balance out the weight. Can I do that? Balance out the extra port there, weight-wise, and, well, I could put a core on it, but I don't think I'm gonna do that, so I have something else in mind. here we go. So this is going to be our transfer vehicle. We're going to have, if I do this right, we're going to have it actually be powered by one of the semi-permanent fuel tanks currently on Jebediah Kerman Station. We're going to hijack one. Use it for this, since it has the AJ-10 that we can no longer put on new builds. So we're going to go ahead and abuse it, since we have it. So what we're going to do... load up the payload fairing. Docking port, obviously. There we go, there's our fairing. Do need some separatrons. Let's tilt them a little more, just to be safe. That should be clear of the solar panel. And alright, now we have a 14-ton payload. Now, the trick here, this is not going to have its own core. So we now need to make considerations for having a core on the actual craft. Frankly, a bad idea. This is gonna get kind of wobbly. But you know what? We're just gonna deal with it. Should give us a 15-ton payload. Which means I might want to try out the K-15, although realistically I should be trying to count on there being extra fuel. So I'm gonna probably use the K-18 again. Desperately try and strut all this together so it doesn't... Wait a minute. Don't need to do that. Don't need to do that. Steve, you are smarter than this. There we go. Problem solved. And we are kind of overkill right now, overkill mode, since this is 14 tons. We're going to throw a little more fuel on. your engines, solids, and towers. We need these solids. Different spot. Those to separate, and this separates. Those need to separate on their own. Right after here. This is the second stage. Let's go right here. Fairing separation should go right about there. Should probably right about there. And that would separate that off. Which is actually probably not even how we want to do that, is it? Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Okay. That should be fine. Just made such a wishy-washy move of this. I'm sure no Kermit are trying to go along for the ride. Good. No Kermit. So I'm going to launch this to Jeb Station. We are going to dump any excess fuel onto Jeb Station. We are going to fill up one of the semi-permanent fuel tanks on there. We are going to send a crew up to get inside this vehicle. We are going to then go and rendezvous with the lander, and then we are going to go all the way out to Midmus. We'll probably rendezvous the lander with this. So, probably not all going to happen tonight, because that's a lot of stuff. It's a long laundry list. Okay, Dean on the way. Slightly overloaded. Forgot to time this out with the station, so that was really smart. One of those times I wish I let myself use prefer. No. So that's that. Deal with it. Terribly off. Considering how cheap the engines are, we're getting quite a lot out of a pair of Thugs and a Reliant. Asking a lot for some very bargain basement engines. Almost from safe altitude to drop a ferry. Really, we're probably already safe. Horizontal speed for our second stage to get started on. And there we go. We're going to ride this up now to the height of our of our flight, our apogee, which is already quite close. So we're probably just going to have to go ahead and do this like now-ish. Yeah, now-ish. Now-ish would be good. Drive that a little more aggressive. Angle of attack. Drive that FG out in front of us. Our periaps a little bit. Nope, other way. So we want to sacrifice our apogee a little bit in favor of our periaps. Rather than just trying to raise our periaps, because we do want to keep ourselves in a low orbit below the station. The more we level it out, the easier that rendezvous maneuver will most likely be. Where we want to go, right about there. And that'll let us catch up to the station. Tiny bit of inclination to correct. We're going to have to make a more radical inclination change later. Thermometer. ourselves a little bit so this is easier to time. Corrected. A little bit of a correction there to our maneuver, and we're good. Now we just need to catch up to the station. Because I launched at a horrible time. I launched at very much not the optimal time to launch. Should do. Speaking of, I forgot that we have a vehicle going for Nedbo's pod as well. It should be a few passes away. This one looks much better. Have much of a speed to cancel out relative to the station when we do it this way. So that much is good. Too hard to maneuver. Just a little more time to do this adjustment. Because we do need to throttle up. At our maneuver, the direction in our maneuver is intended to actually go. Once again, 2 seconds away from our maneuver node, we will start burning. I'm gonna get this just right. Okay. And switch to target and retrograde. Once we get close in, all we'll need to do now is cancel out our relative speed to the station. And we'll get ready to dock with it. When that's done, we'll transfer any remaining fuel out of this. We will then be able to eject it from the rear of this, and then we'll be able to control it to fire its retro rocket. So we are going to actually split those off into different staging. Because I hadn't done that, and that would have been really crappy to leave space debris once again. Let's cancel this a little before we get there, because now I need to actually plan out the maneuver, and I did not do that. So let's see here. So right here, I need to cancel 52.7. So I'm not actually gonna care which way I burn, because I'm gonna let the target tracking do that. I just want to see how many seconds it's gonna take, which is about 4 seconds. So now I can drop a blank maneuver right on our closest intersect. Okay. So that'll tell me about 2 seconds away from our closest intersect, I want to burn full throttle, retrograde to target. Oh, yes, I finally got in loading range of the station. That'll do it. That's a big station, so I just kind of tend to seize up there as soon as I get in loading range. And then they finally start working again. Unlike the old days where they would just completely not work because my computer couldn't handle it. Now it's basically all just down to game mechanics. How the physics engine handles it is really what's causing the freezing, not the computer. I mean, the two graphics cards and the 12-threaded processor, I mean, there should literally be no problem here. Seconds. We're gonna start to burn. I'm gonna trust our math. Yeah, I shouldn't trust the math. I should fire the controller. Still actually really close. Maybe not. Maybe we did just fine. I really need to figure out how to disable those announcements. Okay. Now we just need to figure out where we want to park this sucker on the station. There's a couple options. I could go for the nadir side. Dorsal docking port. But the lab might get in the way of that. These tanks might get in the way of doing that with any of these. Although, idea. I think. Yes. Yes, I think I have an idea. Okay. Time for some deft maneuvering. Creating an echo there or not. Alright. We need to move around the station. just a moment so I can actually keep track of which way is up. Thanks to this unfazed camera angle. No matter what I do, it just feels like having me be this way. Doesn't make a lot of sense. Should give you right side up. Anyway. Station. So much money, bro. What I'm going to try and do shut this off actually just so I don't screw it. What I'm going to try and do is flip this onto its back, so to speak, and dock this dorsal port on the nadir side of the station from an approach coming from the docking adapter for the MUN transfer vehicle. That way, we should have enough clearance to get up and under part of the science module when we do that. That's going to leave this rear port exposed when I go and separate off the spare fuel tank and deorbit it. And we'll be able to take one of these semi-permanent fuel tanks off the station and use that as our primary thrusters on the Minmus transfer vehicle here. Very intricate. That's how we do things here. Go for this dock right here. Still drifting towards the station. I actually don't want to do that yet. There we go. Now we've equalized out our to speed. We're now station keeping. Let's go back to rotational mode. We're now going to flip onto our back and point our nose in towards the station. Howdy. I appreciate the howdy part. All right. Let's line this up. I think the only thing I'll need to do is just disable these two repackable solar panels. Just pack those back up. I think if I do that, I think I'm in good shape. That actually does look really good. One of the more difficult docking maneuvers. I can switch and get this port to be where we control from, which will make that easier now. But I'd like to get it lined up first. It's not going to do us much good. So we're just gonna kind of slink our way under the station here. Nice and easy. Just using this spare room that we have with the MUN vehicle currently off at MUN to go ahead and get this docked. We can afford to go forward a little faster. We look fairly well aligned. Once I get the feeling that we're going to pass under it, I control from here. There we go. Now we're looking good. Basically now heading away from the target. We now want to balance that out. And we're pretty well lined up. Corrections. Increase speed towards it. Can't tell if the docking adapter antennas are gonna clip. I feel like I'm gonna break something here. So we're just going to, while this is still moving, which is probably a bad idea, but we're gonna do it anyway. Retract. If we can just avoid clipping that. Just a little more this way. Using the nav ball to do all the heavy lifting right now. I'm not going to trust eyeball. So eyeballing this typically doesn't work. Just gotta slide it in nice and slow, that's right. Nice and easy. Just give it a little tappy. Tap, tap, tap-a-roo. Looking quite good. I think we've just about got it. Just do a little bit. Beautiful. sure there's no auto strut enabled anywhere. It does tend to kill space stations. Oh, all of this is auto strutted. I don't know how that happened. I didn't think I said all of it. But that's quite alright. Seems good now. And now I can trust SAS again. Without wobbling our station to death. Alright, so now. What we want to do, we want to transfer most of our fuel, if not all of our fuel. Probably all of our fuel. Out of this, and then into one of these tanks. Which is going to end up being this one, because this one actually has all the RCS on it. And that is going to be our new transfer vehicle, since we can no longer launch new AJ-10 engines. We're going to use the ones we got. Just think, we were wasting them on fuel tanks. Wow, all these are already full. Not the transfer here. Wow. Alright. Let's throw fuel in here, then. How much time's gone into this station? That's a mighty good question. I think I really maybe have 15 hours in it, I think? Something along those lines? Maybe more. Maybe more with the crew rotation. I think the moon station definitely took a lot more of my effort. Only because that one got really buggy. Do I have any fuel tanks that are actually empty? This is an interesting problem to have. I don't have anywhere to dump the fuel. There we go. Some of the transfer vehicles can hold it temporarily. Some of the capsules. Excited for is our Minmus station. We'll finally start doing all of our interplanetary missions based from there, if all goes according to plan. And start using it as our refueling depot, since we'll be mining on Minmus very shortly. Is there a goal for the station besides being a station? Not particularly. This is basically just a jumping point. We do have just the one science bay on there. But this kind of just works as a staging point for the other two stations. This way I'm able to assemble larger crews together. Moon Station's the fun one, because the Moon Station, that one's got basically station-launched landers. So that one is definitely beneficial. We'll be doing the same for Minmus, but our landers there will be much more complicated since they're going to have mining drills on them. Alright, last bit of fuel. Might save that tiny bit of fuel just to try and deorbit this. Yeah, I might do just that. So we're looking for this guy. Excellent, that's going to give us some momentum away from the station. Anything when we do that. good. Yeah, I think we're clear. So we're going to use what fuel we have to clear the station. And we can flip over prograde. Prograde, now we can fire. And we're good to switch away from that guy before it enters the atmosphere. And I've got a few other missions to check in on. See how they're doing. Oh. Worry about moving this craft over once we have a crew transferred over. I will have to launch one more capsule up just to have enough crew for the Minmus transfer here. So what we really want good. Oh wait. No, not good. Still a good distance. I was gonna say, I thought cleanup probe was finally near Nedbo's old pod. Do need to do all with that and get rid of the space debris because I hate having it there. Let's see. Surveyor 2's probably got still a little while before it's due to do its circularization, so we can start scanning. Yep, still got a very long time till it's in its position. It's only 4 days worth. Surveyor 1 still doing its job. Let's kick it back to the moon station real quick. Use this opportunity to finally refuel that lander that I completely drained the fuel on our last landing. So I don't forget it next time, because I will forget it next time. And we need to start trying to work on at least one more contract landing. We got one more contract landing near our broken lander. Alfado. TZNLT Alfado. That's where we will have to do our temperature scan. Right, we are almost through. Supply here. How's your day been? Pretty good. Had my return to my real life job today after a very long break, but I really can't complain. Gotta keep my mind busy. How about you? How's your day been? You've got the floor, so to speak. Officially about to be out of fuel. New socks, so your day is good. I can totally get on board with that. I've now reached that age where on Christmas when I get socks, I'm excited instead of disappointed. Signs you're old. Excited when you get socks and ties. Music kind of drowns you out a bit. I'm surprised it's actually that loud. I was trying to mess with that earlier. We'll tune that down a little ways. See if that helps. It might just be me losing my voice a little bit. Because I do feel that coming. So I'll leave myself just a little bit of monoprop on this. And a little bit of fuel. And between the two, I should be able to deorbit this and get it into a moon impact, not leave any debris in space. I'll worry about leveling out our monoprop later. Hang on. Why is that transferring both of those? That's better. Alright. That one's empty. That one's empty. These ones don't have a lot of monoprop in them. But I'm going to just transfer two of them over. Keep the other two full, where they are at least. I actually don't need to transfer that much. There we go, there's a good place to transfer. So our transfer vehicle here, this basically makes the transit between both stations. So that's the main purpose of the Jebediah Station. Jebediah Kremen Memorial Station, unfortunately. He died for science. Actually, he died doing what he loved, which was hijacking vessels he wasn't supposed to be on. Enough playing around with fuel limits. Let's disconnect this thing. And use just a tiny bit of RCS to clear the station. Staging mode and retrograde. Sounds like a fun time with the boys. Okay, why is... Okay. Ha! So I need to activate the engine. Typically you want the engine on. I should remember that. Want docking mode again. RCS off. RCS on. Just a little bit of extra retrograde burn. Just to make sure. Make sure this smashes in the moon instead of just having a low. And there we are. That should be, yep, blowing up. One of my favorite things, blowing up space debris. This one I don't mind watching explode. Actually, fairly close to our previous landing zones. There we go. This is regular speed. This is going to be quite the impact. There we go. Beautiful. It's always fun to do that. Let's go back to the Space Center. Because now... either going to be doing some time warp, or I'm going to be looking at a new contract. I try to do a minimal amount of time warping. Since we're still only on day 142. We've done a lot in 142 days. I wish things actually went at that pace. Not both, it's true. Not a bad idea. I want to see what I have for contracts, so. Though. Oh, I really don't want that recover. Recover components. That one's going to be a pain in the butt, because I did not save the vehicle that's designed for that. So what I am going to do, I'm going to launch the crew that I needed to launch up to the station. So I can start getting them on their way to Minmus. So I'll have to pick out a good crew for Minmus. For that, we want, where are we? Launch vehicle D. Here we are. Staging check. Engine, towers, boosters. Separate. Second stage. Bearing drop, deorbit the second stage, main engines, separate for re-entry, drogue chutes, main chute. Perfect. So now, I am not going to let the game choose my, my crew. I want to pick my own crew. So we've got, Newstead is a veteran pilot. He's planted the flag on the moon, so that's pretty darn good. I do need some good scientists. I will need an engineer. I think I have a spare engineer already up on the station. Brand new, so we're gonna try and get him some experience. Send one rookie on the ride. One veteran, send Newsy. Newsy and Newstead, it's almost like meant to be there. Send them on their way. Yes, exactly. That's actually the plan. So right now we've got a Minmus station in orbit, at least under construction. It is set up as a deep space gateway. That's the phrase I'm looking for. And I have a nuclear-powered transfer stage there, so that'll be our planetary transfer vehicle. This time, I'm actually going to remember to time this with the station. So this is going to be our target. We are going to let it come around into the optimal launching position, so we don't have to wait an extra long time. So So optimal launch position should be right there. So I think I just overshot it, but that's fine. I almost need like a primer for everybody just to know where I'm at. It's a little mix of NASA's original STS plan and plan that had to do originally with the Constellation. Combination of just canceled NASA projects. Actually, then pause for a second. I don't know why I have that so off, and I'm gonna mess with my settings. Let's crank it right about there. That should do the job. Some flight. And prograde and second stage. Should be at this point still driving apogee. Just level out. 50,000 meters, safe altitude to drop the fairing. Don't need that anymore. Now, working on catching up to the station, if at all possible. And I goofed again. Let's bring that back up. And there we go. Now just working on orbital velocity. So that's it for solar panels. Might have to leave us in a slightly lower orbit so we can catch up to the station. By the looks of it. So let's cancel our burn for the moment. Plan out circularization maneuver. Keep below the station. So we have a 1 minute, 3 second burn, so yeah, at about 35 seconds away from the maneuver node, I'm going to start our burn once again. Happy New Year. I actually had it up on the text there yesterday, but I couldn't resist putting something up for the Ultima Thule flyby. Just make orbit with the second stage. It's making me think that they might have changed some stats here on the cheetah that I wasn't aware of. No, it looks the same. 125 thrust, 355 specific impulse. Maybe I just had a little extra steering loss, which is probably the case. Probably pilot error tiny bit of fuel left in that to try and do some maneuvers. Let's see if we can set up a rendezvous. Not too bad, actually. We can work with that. We can make that happen. Need to raise orbit slightly. Reposition once again. Point 6. Have any inclination difference? We've got quite a bit of inclination difference. Well, let's see what happens if we do that here. That's an ascending node. There we go, 0, 0. That should mess with our apogee a little bit. Yeah, it seems to. Lower that back down a little ways. Getting good there. Now it's just a matter of timing. For that, we'll do the radial adjustment and point one. Fantastic. And we'll get there with the second stage. That's more what I was expecting. That's more on par. Brown maneuver. It's only going to be a 2-second burn. Looks like we're fairly on target. Might be just a little low on our pitch. But we'll see. So 1 second from maneuver. Hit full throttle. Yep. I was right. Just a little low on our pitch there. So now we'll have to correct that.